Welcome to the Wrestle Ropes podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. I've done a couple SWN podcast recordings this week, so bear in mind, I will probably forget the name of my own show. But I am joined on this edition of the podcast. You can see it in the title screen. We're previewing Clyde Valley Wrestling's first show this Saturday in Strathaven, and I'm joined by the owner, the promoter, whatever you want to call him within reason. It's Craig Forsyth. Welcome to the show.
Hi, Billy. Thanks for having me.
So I'm very excited for this one because it's a pretty packed card for a debut show.
Yeah,
we've got going on. So we'll speak about the inception of Clyde Valley Wrestling, yeah. And then we'll get into the card itself. But for those that have just started listening and thought, I don't want to listen to Billy's voice for an hour again, I'll just tell you the information now. Saturday, 12th of March, Strathaven Scout and Guide Centre, door 6:30 PM, show begins 7 PM. £10 adults, £7 under 16s, £25 family of four. For your tickets, go to clydevalleywrestling.co.uk. Right.
And Billy's just got himself barred from Strathaven.
Oh, Strathaven. To be fair, it does say on the poster, Strathaven.
That's how it's spelled.
with two H's.
Right. Oh, no, that was Adam. That was Adam.
All right, Adam. So it's Adam's fault here.
You're the old poster.
So it's Strathaven.
Right.
Strathaven, yeah. Right, that down. Apologies to the people that are from Strathaven. I mean, I did wonder, because Strathaven's up this way, and I was like, right. Isn't it weird that there's two places called Strathaven?
Yeah.
Anyway, Strathaven. Okay. How's it going? How you doing? 2 days, a day out from Clyde Valley Wrestling's debut show. Nerves? Yeah. Anxious? How's it? How's it going?
You probably, well, as you probably know, I slept in there, so nerves are starting to hit me.
So Clyde Valley Wrestling.
5 minutes late.
it's fine. I've had worse. I've had people cancel like Aye. 5 minutes before the show starts. So it's absolutely no bother at all. You're here. That's the most important thing. So we'll just go for the start of Clyde Valley. So this show was actually supposed to be end of last year. I think it was. Initially, it was going to be the debut event. What made you decide to start your own promotion? To start Clyde Valley Wrestling.
It probably goes all the way back to kind of summer 2020. Obviously, everything happening, kind of I fell out with wrestling like most people did. Kind of left for a little bit and didn't know what I was going to do. Then a couple of close friends, I was interested in getting into the business side of things. And as a couple of close friends said to me, well, why don't you start running some shows? And I kind of thought about it. And then just one thing led to another, and next thing I know, the company's registered and we're up and running. That was July last year. So it's kind of a long process, properly thinking about it. But it's something I've been thinking about for a few years now.
And the Clyde Valley name is just because that's the area. Any inspiration?
I was trying to think of a name one night, and I was driving through kind of like Lanark and Lark Hall, that kind of area, and every other sign was Clyde Valley. I'm like, Clyde Valley Wrestling's got a bit of a ring to it, and it just stuck.
But sometimes it's just the easiest, some simplest things that kind of make it easy just to decide. So CVW is Clyde Valley Wrestling coming up this Saturday, like we're saying, because this is the preview show. So that was the inception of it. So you said you kind of fallen out. I think everyone listening to this knows kind of stuff that happened last year. We're not going to get into it because, no, year before. The years are all just a blur now.
Yes, excellent.
So when you were kind of putting together that first card, of course, the show that unfortunately had to cancel, was it just in mind of guys that you've worked with, first of all, like from Source and from like just around Reckless and all that kind of stuff? Who's your first sport call?
Kind of guys from Source, guys who I thought I got on with and I kind of thought deserved a chance as well. And then also kind of a mix of up and comer from elsewhere. And then I've also got Eric Canyon in. Someone with a bit of experience in them. So just a kind of a good mix of up and coming and current talent. Just try and mix it together.
Well, let's have a look then. Let's see what card we've got on in store. So, of course, you can check the full card on Clyde Valley Wrestling's on Facebook. You do have a Twitter page, so just Facebook, no. Instagram.
I'm terrible with social media. It's bad enough. Facebook and Instagram.
Fair enough. So get the full card there. It's also on our site, swnscotland.com. We put out all the announcements when they come out very quickly afterwards, because if I don't put them out as soon as the announcements go up, I will forget. That's pretty much the rules. So if anyone asks, anyone's wondering why my announcements go out so quickly after they go out by companies, it's because I will not remember to do it. So the first match that we've got that we're going to go through on this preview, we've got so many to pick from, so we'll just pick randomly. You mentioned Eric Kanyon, so we'll start with his match there. So Eric Kanyon against Taylor Veit. So this is very much experience against cunning, I suppose. Taylor Veit is all about the tactician, smartest wrestler in Scotland, the world, whatever he wants to play it as. When you're putting together kind of matches like this, was that just a case of wanting to give Taylor a chance to go in with someone, the experience of Eric Kanyon, and what are your thoughts of what you're kind of expecting from this match?
That's exactly that. Kind of trying to give him a good experienced opponent, give him a good challenge, and also something I can market as Brain versus Braun. So kind of old school mentality fashion as well. Taylor's one of the guys I kind of think he could do with a breakout match. I think former four-time Scottish heavyweight champions, certainly someone to try him against.
Absolutely. I mean, he's faced pretty much everyone that you can think of that's went from Scotland to the big time. No doubt he's probably had a match with Drew Galloway at some point. He's definitely had matches with Demo. I know that for a fact. Yeah. And so, yeah, anyone you can think of, he's probably interacted with sub-description with. Yeah. And it's a good test to put them in there. So, yeah, Brain versus Braun. Like I say, that's the way you're marketing in the match itself. Have you been in the ring with Kanyon, Eric Kanyon, before?
Yes, once for Reckless. I'm a big bit of a guy. And he was still able to throw him a bit like a wet trackie. He's scarily strong.
So Taylor's going to have to do a little bit.
He's going to need to use all of that brain.
All that brain. Have you been in the ring with Taylor before? Is it?
I don't think so. I think I've trained with him for a few years. I think I've trained with him since he started training at Soar. So I know what he's like in the ring. So it's just going to be, let's see if he can hang with the big boys.
So how's the roof situation in Strathaven?
Very tall.
Excellent.
Very tall.
So Taylor's going to be, his ankles will be safe. He's not going to be getting the roof at any point. Excellent. That'd be good for him to know, I suppose. Yeah. Hopefully, of course, he'll be avoiding that at all costs. But Brain versus Braun, Taylor Veit versus Eric Kanyon. This is going to be, both competitors are going to use both of their skill sets very well in this. That's why you put the match together. Excellent. That's a nice quick one to start off with this preview. Right. We won't get into your match. We'll get into your match near the end because it's your match. So we'll skip that one in my list here. We're just going to go Lucha DS versus Zero in our preview next. Because this is interesting. This is definitely... stark contrast, chalk and cheese kind of thing here. You've got Lucha DS, High Flyer, Death Defying, Lucha, and then you've got Zero, who is spooky. Yeah,
exactly. That's another one. The match writes itself. That was actually the very first match I wrote down on a sheet of paper when I was thinking about running the show. The very first match I thought about was Zero and Lucha DS. It's just the contrast. I'm a big Marvel fan, and it's the big superhero against the supervillain.
So I'm hoping. I mean, that means you're hoping then Lucha brings his Spider-Man gear because it's my favorite of his gear. It's just the best. Zero, a guy that you would have had some interaction with then, because again through Source, Lucha, he appears everywhere. If there's a wrestling show on, he's going to try and get himself onto it somehow, some way. He just wants to wrestle, which is an admirable trait to have. He just wants to, because he does every so often, very rarely now, but every so often he'll contact me and go, "What shows are on this weekend?" "Oh, these are the shows." "Okay." And then somehow he ends up on them. It's just a guy who wants to wrestle. So when you approached him, he said that was your first match you wrote down. When you approached Lucha to be on the show, was it just an absolute yes straight away? Was he even curious who he was facing at that point? Was it just a yes?
No, just, yeah, straight away. I think he's just happy to be everywhere. I think he's just happy to get out of the house like everyone else. Met him. Well, I was on the first time being on a show with him just the other week at Source. So again, I know it's going to be someone I can get on with backstage as well. So looking forward to it. Again, he's everywhere. So I think we're kind of lucky to have him at this point as well. It's going to be a case of get him in early if I can.
Well, yeah, and he's a big fan favourite, of course, because everyone loves Masks. Yeah, that's just the best thing. Like that Rumble, Masks, Rumbles, bald people. They all get the biggest reactions when it comes to the shows.
And chickens, of course.
all the things that you want in a show. I'm just having a look through the rest of the guys you got on the show. There's a couple might get the bald chant that might be lucky enough to receive it.
Definitely main event.
Definitely. I mean, it's two-thirds. We'll get into it, but it's two-thirds of...
two-thirds in the main event.
Oh, that's going to be a very loud night.
Yeah.
in Strathaven. I'm going to keep saying it so I don't get it wrong.
It's fine.
And now it's Strathaven. It's not Strathaven.
Strathaven.
Not Strathaven. So, yeah, and Zero, of course, like you've had some interactions with him. This guy is just, yeah, there's something... Well, it's not even like a little thing. He's just a spooky dude. He's just got this kind of creepy vibe about him. Someone who would have seen him wrestle up close and personal. What's your kind of, if you're kind of trying to plug or market what Zero is to someone who's not sure that when they're coming to the show, how would you describe Zero?
I don't know where you would start, to be honest. Creepy, probably violent, spooky. Kind of anything along those sort of lines. I don't think he travels. I think he just appears. Kind of just appears in a cloud of smoke and he's there all of a sudden. So I've never seen him traveling before.
He just floats to the ring, kind of thing. It's like you're saying. It's that Marvel thing. You come and see this match. It's your superhero, supervillain, Spider-Man against. I'm trying to think of a spooky Spider-Man villain. As a comic fan, you might have a better idea than I will of.
Because I'm thinking he can't compare Zero to anything.
A bit Morbius kind of thing.
That's the closest thing. Morbius
that'll do. So yeah, if people are looking for your superhero fight, because this is a variety show. That's what wrestling should be, a variety show. And we've just kind of given two absolute opposite ends of the spectrum when it comes to wrestling. When we're speaking about Eric Kanyon versus Taylor Veit, and then Lucha DS versus Zero. When you're kind of aware, again, the rest of the matches in a sec, but were you kind of aware that you were trying to build this kind of variety show, bit of something for everyone?
I've always been a fan of the three ring circus. Everyone's got its place. So there's a place for everyone. Bring the variety rather than having six matches all the same. But a variety kind of changes up the crowd. If they don't like one thing, they like another.
Oh yeah, I mean, it's always the same. It's the old adage is what I say is like, you come to the circus, you might like the clown, but you don't want to see 3 hours of clowns. You want to see a trapeze act or something like that. You want to see something different.
The strongman or the...
Absolutely, and this has kind of got that in spades. And speaking of strong, then, we'll just go to Brody Adler versus Aisha Raymond.
Oh, yeah.
See this banner we've got? These segues just flowing. Brody Adler versus Aisha Raymond. So this is a match that has happened quite often. I think it's been Target, down at probably in Fierce Females at some point, down at Source. So this is your strong woman match that you've got there. Is this one you've seen and you thought, I need to bring this to Strathaven and get this on my show?
Well, I know I'm good friends with both of them. So that was kind of one reason for having them on. And then I know they're working really hard at Renegade, both of them together. So I know the chemistry is going to be there. Again, it's your old experience against your up-and-comer. Aisha's been about forever, it seems like, and this is Brody's chance to come through the ranks and get her name out there. Well, it's already out there, but it's a chance for her to get claim a scalp.
Well, I mean, Aisha Raymond, of course, I mean, I've done countless stuff, previews now, which shows she ends up being on. Again, another one that just if you're going to a show, she'll end up being on it somehow, some way. And she's, of course, been Japan, everywhere in Japan. She's been in Europe. She's been in the US. She's been Of course, WWE for the Mae Young Classic. So she's literally done everything she could possibly do, and now she's got her own promotion going as well. Yeah. And there's nothing that seems to be, if Aisha Raymond puts her mind to it, she will accomplish it some way, somehow.
Definitely.
And then other side is Brody Adler, who of course I've interviewed her, I've spoken to her about Renegade shows and stuff like that, and I'm always just so enamored by her passion for wrestling, because folk forget that before pandemic she had like 3 matches, something like that.
Yeah, something like that.
Five maybe max. And then she came out of the pandemic this absolute monster of just confidence and again passion of I mean, know yourself. You said after everything that happened, you didn't have passion for it, and this is how you kind of reclaimed it by going, right, if I can't control who's in charge of shows, I'm just going to make my own show with I was going to go into a Futurama quote, but I can't because it's a family show. So I think if people know it, they'll know it. And Brody's been one of those that could have faded away in obscurity and done nothing, but she came out like just bursting. She's in Fair City, she's in Target, she's in Renegade, and now she's popping up to Clyde Valley Wrestling as well. So this is definitely someone that you need to keep an eye on, really. And you're kind of getting in the ground, getting her at the ground floor. Much like you're saying with trying to get Taylor Veit out a bit more as well. You're just getting all these guys just in so you can say that, well, not so you can say, oh, I had them when, but
yeah, so it's just so them. Can help as well, help them produce. Again, giving them these good matches against the kind of talent, win, lose or draw, they're going to learn somewhere or another. It's definitely going to take something.
I mean, from your own experience coming up as well, we'll do a whole other interview sometime in the future. But that was opportunities that you were given, that you were able to kind of expand your knowledge and what you want to do. When it came to doing this show, though, did you approach, you said you had a kind of some friends and support and what have you, but was there any other promoters that you kind of tried to pick the brains of, or was this all stuff you kind of picked up along the way?
No, there is some. When I started, it was SWA and Source. So I had a friend of mine contacting kind of demo and stuff. So he's kind of giving me third help information. I think that's an exclusive for you. Not a lot of people know that. Robert Wishart as well. We've been back and forth with messages. That's kind of it just now. But there's a lot of people, kind of David Devlin as well. He's been helping a lot, kind of with what guys are coming through, kind of Source. That's how I've got, we'll speak about it in a minute, Darren Blair and Colton Davis coming in. Again, it's opportunities for them.
Of course, I mean, David, of course, has a hand in Source now, and of course, Robbie Wishart, who has taken a step back from wrestling and is now going all in on Source Wrestling as well. So there's a lot of minds going about, and we already mentioned Aisha Raymond, Renegade, and Eric Canyon, who's been everywhere. So there's a lot of people that will have if you press in front of them, there's always that opportunity to go elsewhere. So I mean, for likes of I'm just going through this list here, but for likes of like Logan Smith, for example, if he puts in a good show in and David Devlin is pressed, you can see him on the next Source show. Or if Aisha Raymond, because Renegade's an inclusive company, you might see him at Renegade. So it's all, like I say, it's all these opportunities that you're providing, and at the same time you're able to put on a show in your kind of hometown area as well. So it works for everyone. Everyone's happy. Everyone gets a tick, I suppose.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, it's networking as well. So it's just getting everybody out there.
That's it. Yeah, networks seems to be the buzzword for pro wrestling nowadays, and it certainly works. So it's not these days of territories, or if you work for that company, you can't work for this one.
It shouldn't be. But I'm open to anyone, really.
It's as long as you're a good wrestler, as long as you're welcome to be involved, then this should be allowed. So we'll go into the tag match next. Then, so we've got, as you mentioned, again these segues. And you mentioned Darren Blair, so we've got Darren J. Blair and Scott McManus against KOE, Kai Williams King and King Killer. So KOE, of course, they've been on the WWE Network now. They've been popping up just everywhere that you can think of again. And you come up against a kind of a mismatched team of Scott McManus and Denny J. Blair. When you're putting these two guys together, was it just a case of you wanted to get these guys on the show, put them in as a team, or was there any further thought in putting this team together?
Originally, it was an open challenge. KOE came to me and said they will take on any two competitors I can find. Darren hit me a message going, I want the chance. So I said, you find somebody, when you go, you can have it. And he got half a tag partner in Scott McManus.
Of course, yeah, one half of the working men's club himself. He'll be, I don't know if he'll be taking time and a half or whatever, any puns you can think of for working men's
club. Sure, I've had plenty of times with Scott. He's been one of my closest friends for 2014. So, plenty of puns. I think we've had our share of them through the years.
So, yeah, a bit of a wild tag team, wild card kind of tag team we've got going. And Denny J. Blair, just coming off a really hot run in Source as well. He's just had this kind of first big moment, of course, when he had that match with Robbie Wishart in his last match in Source Wrestling, which I'm hearing it was just an absolute storm. It was just amazing.
I believe it went 30 to 35 minutes long, just them battering each other.
It was voted our number one match of the month of February as well. So a lot of people clearly enjoyed it that were at the show. I mean, hopefully it'll go on YouTube. Sure it will. I think Robbie was saying that.
I think he was planning on filming it,
I had to get extra memory cards because they didn't have memory cards at the last Source show. And
heard about that one.
So hopefully we'll get to see it on YouTube soon. I'll get to have a look and give my uneducated review of the show because everyone clearly enjoys that. So I'm looking forward to that. But yeah, so Scott McManus, Mr. Hapjutsu on half of the Working Men's Club, Darren J. Blair, young, up and coming, like you're saying, you want to give these guys a chance on the show. But KOE, they kind of, they're a bit wild in their own right. They come in with a bit of a swagger, and then I think they've caused near riots on shows, if I know rightly.
But to me, KOE are the best tag team in Scotland, or the best Scottish tag team just now. Again, they've got they're cocky, they've got the swagger, but they've got every right to have that, if you ask me. I think they've earned it over the years, and they kind of deserve it.
Definitely a well-oiled machine. Of course, they've been going in the ring with the likes of The Purge and Luke King Sharp and Krieger. So they've definitely been in with some of the premier tag teams in Scotland, at least. And then the likes of like Aspen Faith and all those kind of guys they've put on fantastic showings with. It'll be intriguing. We'll use that intriguing tag team.
Definitely.
Match. We've got this team that's thrown together against an established team like KOE. Before we get into like the title match, we'll get into your match, and then we'll do the big title match to round off the preview itself. But before we do that, we'll give the information a plug again, because try to make this a professional podcast. If you're interested in going to Strathaven Scout and Kite Centre, you can do on Saturday, 12th of March. Tickets are available at clydevalleywrestling.co.uk, and you'll find out who the next guest is for the next show, but we'll speak about that before we wrap up. Door 6:30 p.m. Show begins at 7. £10 for adults, £7 for under 16, £25 for a family of four. Usually two adults, two children. That's generally how it works. I've always found that weird, family of four, and then you go, is that an adult with three kids? But no, traditional sense is usually two adults, two kids. So you can find out more on Facebook as well and everything in between. But we're going to continue with the show then with your match. So you're going in the ring. I don't know how long it took to get negotiations together to get you wrestling on the show, but I assume it wasn't very long. But you're going against...
The mirror got a bit dirty, but we got there. The budget was stretched.
You're going against the apparently undefeated with the bunny ears, Colton Davis.
Yeah.
So a big lad that you're coming in the ring with.
Technically he's undefeated. I don't know how big he was until Source the other week. 6'6", 19 years old. I don't know what I've signed myself up for.
It was one of those you signed on dotted line and thought, ah, that'd be nice, give him a bit of a chance. And then you saw him and went,
he texted me saying he's undefeated. Technically, he is 0-0. It's undefeated, he's not lost yet. Text me at 3 in the morning, he wants the biggest, baddest man I can find, and at 3 in the morning, that was me.
Well, if you wake up a man at 3 o'clock in the morning, they are the biggest and baddest.
Yeah, oh, of course. So he must have sent me about 7, 8, 9 messages. He's undefeated, he's the best man, he can do this, that. I'm like, oh, I'll do it. It's like that Burnison, I'll do it.
It's like, again, you woke me up at 3 o'clock, I'm going to batter you for that alone. Like, yeah. The rest of it as well.
That's it. I don't think you'll be getting the King of Fun style that night.
I've spoken to Colton before in the past, and 6'6", 19, that's just a freak athlete in wrestling. You don't get them often, especially in Scotland. Anyway, there's not that many guys that are 6 foot, that are 6'6", hanging around. Maybe a couple that you can think of top of your head, maybe like ADM's close.
I was going to say he towers over ADM, so I think there's 2 inches in that one.
So that's a terrifying prospect. So, and like
and you he's say, bulked as well. So
he is,
he's not a skinny kid anymore. He's bulked out. I think
last time I spoke to him, he was a skinny kid. That's about a year ago. So that's just showing the evolution of Colton Davis coming in. And yeah, and he wanted the biggest and baddest, and you went,
that's 3 o'clock in the morning. So. Exactly.
We'll get into the King of Fun style, because that's your kind of moniker.
Yeah.
What was the idea behind the King of Fun style?
I remember trying to find the name. It was just after I debuted, and it was kind of started doing kind of the comedy gimmick. I was like, I need to try and find a name. And it was David Wilson, the photographer. And I think everybody at that stage was doing King of something style. So I did just the King of Fun style, and I thought about it, I'm like, that works. And then I think it was a Source double weekender. I think the Saturday we were in Bridgeton, the Sunday we were in the Source unit, and it was kind of the Saturday night I decided to change it. Well, may as well try it out. And we did, and since then it stuck.
It's always a worry when you try to do a comedy gimmick that you're often going to be compared. It's just a Greedo kind of thing. So where you kind of have that in mind, you try to do something a little bit more different, a little bit more, not Greedo-y.
Yeah, a little bit more serious. Although I've been and reckless, I've been on some shows with Greedo. He loved the character, so if he loves it, then something must be good.
Absolutely. I mean, if the guy you're going to be compared to loves it, then there's no way that people can criticize it, because you know Greedo likes it, and he's still, I mean, he's wrestled like once maybe in the last year or so, and he's still the biggest star in Scottish wrestling. So
of course
you kind of argue with that. Colton Davis, he says he's undefeated, which he is in Clyde Valley Wrestling, like he says 0-0. But what's your kind of, for him, I suppose he has got a little bit more footage to gather from yourself, like through Reckless and that, so he'll know a bit about your fun style a bit more than you'll know about his. But as someone who's been to Source, what's your kind of, I don't want the whole game plan, because of course you might listen to this, but is there any kind of match inspirations that you've been watching, Mysterio versus Kali, kind of stuff like that? this kind of, you're taking some inspiration from?
That's more of a tomorrow issue than the night before. I'm not taking it lightly, because I watched him and Lucha DS. He battered Lucha, but at the end, it's just going to be Lucha got the better of him. I think if he tries to be cocky and he tries to be arrogant, I'm pretty sure I can sneak up and get the win that way. I think he's going to have to be switched on the full match, rather than if he switches off, he's going to be punished.
So generally, it's tomorrow Craig's problem. That's the...
Tonight's problems, waking up and trying to dust myself off and get all the businesses side of things done.
That's the thing.
Match prep.
You made this match because you woke you up at 3 o'clock in the morning, but when it comes to the show itself, is this kind of, because this is your first show, you're promoting yourself and putting it all together, was this kind of like your little scheduled like break from the thought of the show itself? It's like, right, okay, I've got the whole day to think about this. I'm going to get all set up. I'll have 20 minutes, batter someone, and I'll go back, and then we've got the rest of the work to do. And
yeah, that's it, pretty much. Go backstage, enjoy the rest of the show, and yeah, that's it. Hopefully, enjoy the night.
So when it comes to, I don't know what's like with the crowd, what your kind of ticket sales are. I don't need to know that. I'm not a journalist.
Yeah.
But I'm just going to assume it. But it's looking like it's going to be a good crowd coming to the Clyde Valley.
Well, for the first show, we're looking good. We're under 20 tickets left. And I've had people messaging me asking if tickets will be available. So we are down to the limited available on the door sort of thing. It's just annoying me. I've had 20 tickets left in the last week.
So for whatever reason, people, if you listen to this on Friday, which is when it goes out, and you still haven't got your ticket, just give them a shout. Give Craig a shout. Go to ClydeValleyWrestling.co.uk, and then I've been saying that address without even checking. It is .co.uk. Sweet.
Yeah,
ClydeValleyWrestling. Yeah. You would have corrected me, I'm sure.
I made that mistake on an email.
But no, I'm sure you would have corrected me, but as you already have with Strathaven.
Strathaven.
Yeah. So. Damn, I'm blaming. I'm gonna blame Adam. It's Adam's fault.
Blame Adam.
That's the thing. Because when I saw the poster and then I saw the graphics come with, I was like, "Where's that H from?" I don't know. I don't know what's happening, but it's definitely Strathaven. So you don't want to come up the northeast and go right. Where's this guide house and where's this guide scouting guide center? You're going to be kind of lost a little bit.
Yeah, it's a scouting guide center, but it's not. They're kind of small, it's a big, massive hall, so that's what I'm looking forward to as well.
So when you scouted the venue, pardon the pun, so is this a venue that you're kind of familiar with, going to, I don't know, younger or anything like that?
I think I was trying to find the kind of remote villages. No, I don't know, Strathaven's one of those ones that's kind of too big to be a village, not big enough to be a town.
Right.
And then I'd noticed, I think it was actually the Reckless, I'd noticed it was Scout Hall. And I'm like, I wonder if there's any Scout Halls around this way. Typed it in and Strathaven came up and I found some pictures and this is perfect. Went to view the hall and fell in love with it straight away. A couple of venues I've done that with now. I've got one coming up in August down the Borders. Just walked into the hall and fell in love with it.
Well, someone who's wrestled enough times now to know what makes kind of a good venue.
Yeah.
I suppose Scout Halls would be, like you're saying, it's got a good high ceiling, so good for the high flying stuff, and it's got a bit of an echo as well, usually the Scout Halls. Yeah,
nice big stage as well for the entrance. I'm kind of all about production as well. It's got a nice big stage for the entranceway. So I've got pictures in my head what it's going to look like. Hopefully it can look like that on the day.
I like that. There's a venue in Rothes, like where I grew up, and I love it. It's called the Grant Hall, and not that I'm pitching for you to do a show here, but it's the Grant. It's a bit far away, but no, it's the Grant Hall. And what it is, it's got like two ramps either side of the stage,
and
one goes into one room, one goes behind the stage, and that. And every time I went to go there when I was growing up playing football or that, I just looked at it and went, that'd be amazing for wrestling. Just see it. Mainly because I love like the TNA had the old bad guy entrance and the good guy entrance. I think AEW does it as well now. And every time I saw it, I was like, oh, that'd be so cool if the bad guys came out of one bit, good guys came out the other. And it'd just be
something I'm considering. At the moment, I just have the one entrance way. So the idea is to have it. WCW NW Revenge, good guys one side, bad guys the other. So that's the kind of plan, but someone ruins it. There's always one
always one that goes, oh, which one am I going in, left stage? Yep. Left or
so, big sign, you this way
just a big sign in the middle, just go that way
yeah, and then someone will come through the middle. There's always one.
So yeah, speaking of that then, so you say you're big into the production side of things, and you mentioned that WCW NWO Revenge. Was there anything else when it came to things like the logo or stuff that you, again, kind of took inspiration from? That was there anything that you saw and went, I need some of that in my show?
No, with the logo, actually, it was a friend of mine. He was messaging someone about logos, and they just kind of rustled that up for me, and I'm like, it's different. I didn't ask for the colours. The colours are red, white and blue, which appeals to me, but I was trying to keep that separate from wrestling. But I'm on the suits, so...
I didn't notice, so that's fine. I mean, not that I would.
Yeah.
The footballs are kind of a bit of a mystery to me most of the time. But no, it's a nice kind of clean logo, which is nothing. It's not busy. It's not too wild. You see, I mean, I can't think of many companies in the UK or Scotland anyway that have got kind of a wild logo. But it's nice just to keep it simple.
It's nice. Plus, it's clean. Yeah.
And it's not, and you also done it in PNG on the website, which made it so much easier for me to put a bit on the site where I could just put it on the thumbnail. I was like, perfect, that's fine. It's nice and clean. I don't have to try and clean it up myself, because you know I've already mentioned I'm woeful with technology with this. Try and get me to make graphics. It's just I mean I make everything for this, but some of it can be amazing, some could be absolute horrible. But it's fine. You've got Adam. You've got Adam on the case.
I've got Adam, and for the next show, I feel bad. I need to message him back. I was trying to keep the next show under wraps as much as possible. So I get Darren from Source to do it as well, the next ones.
Which we'll definitely go on to.
We'll get into that, but yeah.
So we'll get the Clyde Valley rest. The last match that we've spoken about, the rest of them. Again, recapping. Eric Carney versus Taylor Veit. Craig Forsyth versus Colton Davis. Brody Adler versus Station Ariamond. Lucha DS versus Zero, and Scott McManus and Darren J. Blair versus KOE, Kai William Kings and King Killa.
Yep.
The main event is a three-way dance.
Yeah.
For the Clyde Valley Wrestling Championship. It will be Logan Smith versus David Devlin versus Griffin.
Yep.
First show, title match, Clyde Valley Wrestling Championship. Have you got the belt?
I've got it. I prepared.
Oh, exclusive!
This is an exclusive. We'll see if I can get it on the camera. Then I've got it.
Here. Oh, that is nice.
Yep. So there we are. There.
That is a beautiful belt, if I do say so myself. I was kind of scared it was going to be the ones that you get where it's just like the like bit, and then you get the picture in the middle, and it would just be your logo. Those ones. Like, I was really scared it was going to be that, but that is a beautiful belt.
It's heavy.
Okay then. I'm definitely asked about belt questions. Again, inspirations. Where were you? How did you design?
Wasn't my design, to be honest with you. So again, it was the same guy that done the logo, that done the two belts. Again, another exclusive. That next one will be coming in April. I'd actually sent him. So he asked about inspiration. For that one, I'd actually sent him the ICW and the Progress belt. And I kind of went, can we mix and match this? And he sent me that design. I'm like, I went for something a bit different. Well, do you know what? It works perfectly. I love that it's different. I think I kind of wanted something that was... The only thing I told him I wanted was black and gold. Just traditional black and gold. And I think that's kind of similar to the TNA one.
Yes, yeah, I was trying to think of the one that was brought in after the NWA.
It's kind of, I always call it the Kurt Angle belt.
Yeah.
He always seemed to have it.
Yeah, that as well. Him and Sting had it a little bit as well. Yeah, so, that's exactly, I was looking at it going, I recognise the kind of shape of it, and that was bang on. It was the TNA belt. Which, you know, it was from the best time, one of the best times of TNA as well, which is never a bad thing to call back to. The guys in this match, it was a bit like, not a bit random. I looked at it and went, okay, this is interesting that you got here. My first question is, I've wrote down three-way dance. Is it a three-way dance?
Yes. Yeah. The whole idea is I don't want one fluke pin.
Okay.
I want it to be earned. So that's why it's a three-way dance. It's elimination. Made that pretty clear on the post. It's just I don't want one single fluke pinfall or fluke. Well, you can't fluke a submission, but you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
Don't want one fluke fall. Just
don't want the winner to earn it.
Yeah, want them to earn it and survive essentially.
Yeah. So bringing in the competitors then. So with David Devlin, of course, we've mentioned him already on this podcast. Wealth of experience. He's heavy-handed. Involved in Source Wrestling as well. So someone that you've definitely had many interactions with over the years, where it be it in the ring or training as well. Was he just like
the very first person I worked with in ring?
Yep. Was he just a no-brainer?
The very first person. Yep. No-brainer. To me, he is probably one of the most underrated in Scotland. I don't think a lot of people know his potential and his worth. Again, hopefully I can give him a chance to raise his profile.
He's no stranger to singles gold, of course. He was a Respect Pro Wrestling champion for a bit. He was tag team champion in Reckless as well. So he knows his way about getting a belt or two. Another guy in this match, then we've got Griffin, of course. Yeah. I don't know if Athena's coming with him, but you may find
out. I've heard rumours she's making an appearance.
Who is she's terrifying.
Oh, scary person.
But Griffin's another guy, like you mentioned about David, I think he's one of the unsung, underrated wrestlers in this country. And thankfully, he's now getting opportunities like at Discovery and of course, at Clyde Valley. So it's great to see him finally he did for a bit. He was at SWA, of course. He was the junior heavyweight champion. He always seems to be the guy that he's on the show, but he's not the show. And you're putting him into the main event to show how good he really is.
Yeah, I mean, even when you look at the wealth of talent on those SWA shows, and he was still, as you know, he's got a pinfall victory over William Ospreay, and as he likes to tell everybody.
I had to try and drag out of him in our podcast with him and Athena, but he did give up the information eventually that he has got a pinfall over Will Ospreay.
Will Ospreay and Rampage Brown, and you know. Him and Rampage, they had some, I think the two, maybe three amazing matches back in the day. Say back in the day, it was like 2015. But now he's another one that's a bit of a change of attitude recently. But now he's still very, very good talent to have.
So, when you're saying back in the day in 2015, I was like, that wasn't that long ago. Oh, God, that was
7 years ago. That was a
while ago now.
Yeah.
I mean, this podcast is going out in a week's time, but I started watching wrestling 10 years ago this August in Scotland. And when I saw that, I thought, oh, God, I had hair when I started watching wrestling in Scotland. It all just migrated down the way. And now it's just, you can't believe, I mean, when did you start in the ring? It wasn't that long ago, was it?
2014 I started training. 2014 it was. Yep. Just keep myself to myself.
Nothing makes you feel older than me. You just go, oh, when did I watch this? Oh, no. It's just like, go back and watch. Like, Rumble season, I always watch past Rumbles. And I watched 2000 was my first one. And I watched it thinking, oh, this wasn't that long ago. And that was 22 years ago. Oh, no. I've watched wrestling for too long now. But here I am now speaking about it for the dozens that like to watch.
Yep.
So David Devlin, of course, no-brainer, like I said. Griffin, again, no-brainer for this match. Logan Smith's an interesting choice, I thought.
He's something I've kind of been keeping an eye on recently. Obviously, he's getting his breakthrough just now as well. I think he could be the wild card in the match, definitely. Like we say, all three of them are probably... Again, Logan's coming through. I wouldn't maybe call him underrated, but... the other, I think it's three wild cards I've got in the main event, but all three of them together, I think I've got potential to steal the show, steal any show they're on, really. Again, it's just getting exposure for them, but Logan's someone I've kind of had an eye on for a while now, and his rise has been great over the past 2 years, maybe, since shows came back. Well, since ICW came back.
Yeah, because he's been on the WWE Network, of course, and through ICW and through Fight Club. He's certainly putting in the work, because he's appearing up in like Caithness for Combat League Wrestling as well, and anywhere that will have him. It seems that, again, it's like that Lucha DS thing. Actually, it's exactly the same as that Lucha DS thing. That if you find a show that they can get to, they'll be on it.
Yeah, because we were talking just a couple of days ago, and. He was saying he's got Friday, Saturday, Sunday this weekend. Two out of three matches are main events. He's an hour title match, and then he's got the world champion on Sunday, the ICW world champion on Sunday, and a non-title match.
So not bad work if you get it.
Weekend for him. He's definitely got stock there.
So he could be walking into the ICW tapings on Sunday just with that beautiful belt, yep. Clyde Valley Championship Wrestling belt, Clyde Valley Wrestling Championship belt. So that means that wouldn't be a bad weekend at all for him. But yeah, it must be when you're younger, I suppose it must be nice to get these just rattling through three matches a weekend. I mean, me at 31, I'd probably be knackered if I was going to three shows one weekend. Yeah. That would be enough for me, let alone actually doing the wrestling on it as well.
So, I'm getting to that stage. I wrestled Hal Reynolds 2 weeks ago and still feeling it.
Hal's a big bruiser. That would have been quite the Titanic battle.
Yeah. Still feeling it. Funny enough, Darren's dad had to help me out the ring. It's not much pain.
So you thought that's fine. 2 weeks, so it'll be nice and healed up for Colton Davis, and now you're again a day or two out, and you're like, oh, maybe not. Not going to be as fresh as I think.
Any money I've got is going to go to sport massages and specialist treatment.
So that's the show. That's we've got, yeah. All the matches then. So again, I've already recapped it before I went into the championship match, but I've got that three-way dance: Logan Smith, David Devlin, and Griffin. If we were to pick kind of a match that if someone came up to you, if they've taken a poster in and went, right, what's the match that I need to look out for? What's going to be the show stealer? Is there any that you're like, it's this one?
There's a couple. Definitely main event, but again, there's an expectation on that. Outside the main event, you're probably looking at Lucha DS and Zero, possibly Taylor Wright and Eric Canyon as well. I think any match could steal the show on the night, even the tag match. I think the tag match could be surprising. I think any one of the matches has got potential to steal the show. I think that's your kind of your big hitters, really.
That's always good when you can go into a card and go, anything, just come to the show and you will enjoy something in this show. I promise you. So yeah, we'll go to speak about April then, because we can't not speak about it. So before we do that, of course, clydevalleywrestling.co.uk, buy your tickets, etc. Bellshill, have I said that right?
Yeah, Bellshill.
Yes. Oh, Bells Hill.
Bells Hill.
I was believing in that H so much. Bloody H's. H's have been my downfall today.
A Lanarkshire thing.
I mean, up here, I mean, I could have mumbled it and it would have been fine. I'm up in the north. I'm up in this Chuchner land.
Yeah.
Orbiston?
Orbiston Neighbourhood Centre.
Right.
The silent T. We like our silent letters.
Right. So Bells Hill, yep. Orbison Neighbourhood Centre, Busby Road, Bells Hill. I'm not going to do the postcode. You can find that yourself. You've got Eric Young coming on February 15th of April. That's a bit of a step. I mean, I'm not saying that the live in Strathaven is going to be just a guy of loads of local talent, which it is. But in your second show, it's Eric Young.
Yep.
How? It was just a case of he was about, and he went, hi.
He was in the area. He had a free night, and well, how it happened was I saw the post going up, and I was like, oh, Eric Young's coming in. He's in the UK. He's got a couple of dates. I was like, do you know what? I'm just going to. It was my again a good friend of mine. He's like, do it. Try your luck. You'll never know. I was like, right, okay. So I just sent a message like, has he got any dates available? And he gave me two dates. All right, okay, let's see what I can do here. And managed to get him in for Friday the 15th of April.
That's a bit of a step up for Clyde Valley. So you come in with a bang with your first show, title match, and everything, with that beautiful belt. And then second one, Eric Young. I mean, have you even started to put a thought on who he's going to face? Or are you going to take this show on Saturday as kind of an audition for people?
So there's three people he could potentially go up against. I should probably start turning clogs. Again, I'm just giving you the exclusives, Billy. Friday 15th of April, it's going to be Eric Young versus, at the moment, vacant, but it will be for the Clyde Valley Wrestling Championship.
Oh, there's just I'm just dragging all these spoilers at you.
Yep. So it's whoever wins the three-way dance, not only did they get the nice belt, the nice pay packet, they also get a match with Eric Young as their first title defence. Potentially last.
Maybe. You know, it's absolutely possible. So Eric Young, of course, we mentioned the kind of TNA parallels we've already discussed with the belt and what have you. So getting Eric Young in, is he a guy that you watched in TNA? Yep. Or
definitely, yeah. Because when I got the deal over the line, I was messaging people, my old guess I've got for April. And they're like, oh, Herbs, I'll give you three clues. One of the clues was always founding member of Team Canada. Oh. From back in the day.
And obviously they went A1. Yeah. Well, he wasn't a founding member if anyone was going to start picking holes in it. No, he wasn't.
Oh, right. I was nine.
No.
I thought he was.
No, I think I could be wrong, but I'm fairly certain he was brought in later. But right. A1, A1 Alistair Ralphs, of course. Absolutely useless, but it was just amazing.
Yeah. I was like nine at the time, so I just remember he was there at the start.
Wow, not only I'll forgive you for making me feel old because you're giving me all these kind of spoilers and exclusives, but yeah, I was a bit older when I saw that for the first time. But so Eric Young, anyone would be, obviously Robert Roode would have been out, but Pete Williams, Team Canada, what a
team.
Probably divine and all the best. But no, Eric Young, former TNA champion, I think it was still TNA at that point, former TNA beer drinking championship, of course, he won that. Obviously NXT as well.
Yeah. And then he won the Impact as well when he came back.
Of course, yes. And he's still currently in there with Violent by Design. And
and he's just won the tag championships.
I did not know that. I'm a little bit behind on my Impact. Yep. But he's
I just saw Pop. I've got him on Twitter now, so.
Of course, yeah. Well,
I'm Joe Doring of the tag champions.
Oh, that's a scary team to have as your champions. Eric Young coming in. I'm assuming he maybe, hopefully people are going to pick his brains during the day and stuff like that.
Yeah.
You'd have to.
Have you
had a long list of texts of people offering to go pick him up and what have you, just to try and get a little extra time.
Kai Williams King was the first person. He's like, so who's picking him up from the airport or who's giving a lift? I'm like, I'm doing it.
Fair. That's
so I can pick his brain, to be honest with you.
That's the owner, that's the promoter's prerogative. They get first dibs and all this kind of stuff as well. They're bringing them in. So Clyde Valley Wrestling, Bells Hill, 15th of April. Tickets are available. Again, you can go into clydevalleywrestling.co.uk. Tickets, I mean, bargain. £10 adult. Again, same price as £10 and as an adult. And you can go meet
These ones are slightly different.
Right.
They're a pound different. £10 adults, £8 kids. Under 16s, family is £30 for that one.
Right, okay, that's fine.
It's not much different, but...
Still, I mean, that's still pretty decent.
Still a bargain.
Absolutely, I've just got the adult one in front of me, and that's why I said £10. Yep. I'm doing very well with this thing. But yeah, £8 children, £30 for a family of four. So yeah, that's again, absolute bargain to meet Eric Young. No doubt you'll have a line a mile long for meet and greets as well, that... who knows, and merch and all that kind of stuff, so it's all kind of good stuff. Absolutely not an important question, but just out of curiosity, because I know there's some tuck enthusiasts out there that know that there's snacks and what have you at these shows, have you been to the Booker's or Cash and Carry?
I'm laughing because I was out last night. I was at the cinema last night and I got out and I checked my phone. Someone messaged the page asking if there was a tuck shop.
Don't call out Stephen Louch like that. He's just...
I wasn't Louch, that was the best part.
Raffle, of course, is there a raffle?
Yeah, there's a raffle.
Has to be a raffle.
Got to be a raffle.
Has to be. So your time doing shows, you're picking all the best bits.
Oh, definitely, yeah.
Brilliant. So, I mean, I don't know much more we can speak about than ending with what there's going to be a raffle. So, there's going to be a raffle, there's going to be a tuck shop, people. So, don't you worry. You're all sorted, Clyde Valley Wrestling, for sure. So, yeah, so we went through the card, we went through everything. Is there anything that, any final push, any final thing that you want to get out there and tell the people that they have to come to this first show, of course, tomorrow?
Yeah, just a case of really. Tickets are very limited right now as well, so I think it'd be, if you missed out, there's a chance you could be disappointed, and I think it's going to be a really good show. Potential there, of, maybe we'll see it on the awards, we never know. Definitely a chance.
Absolutely, there's always a chance. I mean, the awards, even if it's not in the shortlist, we found with Fair City Wrestling, they weren't even in the shortlist, and they were like second show of the month. Yeah. Like, it's all to play for. And those things, which is what I like when I'm doing the awards, a little bit of all play for. Is there a chance this is going to be recorded out on YouTube? Is there any kind of thoughts on that?
Potentially. I'm not the best with recording, so I'm going to try my best. If I can get a good hard cam, then that will definitely, the main event will go up as soon as, and then we'll try and put some other matches up, just depending on camera quality. At the moment, it's my iPad that's going to be doing it. I did have a camera, but it wasn't the best of quality. So, going to be trial and error, like a lot of things. If it's good quality, it'll be up.
Excellent. So maybe we'll get to see some of these matches soon, because there's definitely a few that I'm certainly interested in seeing, especially that three-way, as we said, for the Clyde Valley Wrestling Championship. Well, I think that's a nice way to wrap up then. Like I said, all the information will be available through Clyde Valley Wrestling on Facebook. And thank you very much for taking the time to preview the show with me today.
Yeah, no worries. Thanks again for having me.
Well, thank you very much.
All right, thank you.